Welcome to this new Addon Spotlight. In this Addon Spotlight, we're gonna look at the city of Rotterdam, which received a community update. Yes, a community update, no official update from Asobo, but a community update where they pimped the city massively. The thing is that I would say there are really nice things, right? If you look at these pictures, right, it looks really stunning. So I'm really looking forward to try out these things. You can see several poys, including some of them were already part of the official Flight Simulator content, but there are some new ones which have been added. It's based on Google Maps, as far as I understood. And, well, the thing is, you need to have some disk space and you need to have some time or spend some time downloading the files. Because in total, there are 3 files, and that's also where I want to start is if you are on Flight Simulator 2, where you can get this nice add-on, you can download the city, right? You can see that the initial release was on the 1st of February 2023, and it has been updated to version 1.2 to make it compatible with the other add-ons. So if you click on download now, you need to make sure that you're both downloading the main file, but also the TLXT Rotterdam 2 and 3. And you can see that the zip files are pretty big. Currently I'm downloading them as we speak. So let's see where they are. Well, they almost completed, right? At least one of them still needs to be completed. So let's go ahead then and let's see how we can install them, right? So the installer is kind of pretty easy. In this case, right, I will show you how they will look like if you would open a zip. I'm going to do that with 7-zip. And here you can see the TLXT Rotterdam 1, and then the other ones are 2 and 3. So what you can do is simply extract them using 7-zip or using one of your other favorite tools. And there are 2 ways to do that. You can either extract them here, or you can, of course, directly extract them in the correct folder. In my case, the correct folder is on my C drive. All right, so let's go to it. Where is it? Come on. This PC, MSFS, and then into the communities folder, and then hit OK. It will take some time before it has extracted all the stuff. So I'm not going to, spend time you showing that, right? Doesn't make any sense. While I'm speaking, I'm going to, continue extracting because it speeds up the process. There's one important thing is that you need to do this prior to starting Flight Simulator, right? If you start Flight Simulator, then you really need to restart to see this nice content because it needs to go to the re-indexing process and simply adopt these, new changes before you can really use them. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to pause recording. Then I'm going to, wait till the extraction of the files has completed. And then, of course, start Flight Simulator. So we'll be back in a few seconds. So we're back. We've extracted all the files. And the next thing, of course, is flying. Let's see how the city will look like after this update, right? So we're moving the parking brakes. And let's increase throttle. So the thing which I'm mostly looking at with these kind of things is, how much frames per second impact does it have, right? And I'm not looking with, the meter, which you can, get when you're activating the developer mode. I'm simply looking at, how bad it is, right? If it becomes that bad that you can really see the stuttering, that's something where I sometimes disconnect. But in some cases, you also need to decrease the video setting, right? You saw some stuttering here also, right? So for some reason, in some cases, the video card is, really hammered. And that could also, impact this behavior. So we're gonna turn directly to the left side, right? Because over there's the city. The good thing is that as part of this add-on, there are multiple, additional point of interest which are being added. A few of them are, soccer centers or soccer stadia, but also, a lot of, large buildings in Rotterdam which you can fly over. So we're gonna move our nose into the direction of the city. Now let's go outside, right? Because that's the most interesting part. Let's change the camera angle a bit. So here we go. The good thing is that they didn't focus only on the city center, but also at the rest of the city. So you will see that, large parts of the city received an update, including parts over there, right, where you can see the elevation and I would say more detail, as well as over here. So let's have a look at it, right? So the part which you see in front of us, right, that's the, you say, train station, the main train station of Rotterdam. And as you can see, there are a lot of large buildings over there, right? A lot of, I would say, large office buildings, but also hotels and some other types of buildings, including the Hofplein von Dijn, right, which is, I would say, one of those, or one big fountain at the end of the Kool Single, which we're flying over right now, and there's the City House, as well as the World Trade Center. If you fly in this direction, which we're currently flying, you will eventually end up at the Erasmus Bridge, right, which is the bridge which was already part of Flight Simulator 2020, because it was added as one of the using one of the world updates. But if you don't install the additional content, the buildings which you can now see, which are pretty close to the bridge, they're not looking realistic. And with this graded on, which is based on Google Maps, you can see those details much better. Here you can could see that the, I would say, machine was having it a little bit, say, difficult. But hey, sometimes you need to choose quality over performance. But it of course depends on what you prefer yourself, right? For this, these kind of videos, I like to have more quality, and sometimes I would say need to release that it sometimes is hotter and less of the ring. Keeping an eye on the altitude, but also keeping an eye on the speed, of course. So we're now coming a little bit outside of the city center, right? So you can see that there are, I would say, less details in that part. But still enough, right? Squawk 6767, KLM 467. KLM 467 radar contact 5 miles southeast of Rotterdam. Nice bridges. 500 feet. Cleared through the Charlie airspace. Including cars. Huh, let's have a look. Are there cars driving underwater or over? It looks like under the road. That's what you see with a lot of the, parts, right? So this is not the only part where you can see this behavior. Well, let's make a turnover now and let's see if we can go back to the city center to see the quality there. You can see that this part also, I'd say, looks, I'd say, nice. They also have added some more detail over here. Need to keep an eye on my altitude, because as you can see, the altitude doesn't go that well. And we don't want to land in the city, of course. So, turning around. And then flying back to the city center, right, which is over there. And it's easy to recognize, right, even if you don't know it, if you just follow the point of interest, you will see that you will find the city center itself. A lot of detail also in this part. So some elevated buildings, and if you change the angle a bit, you can see that the quality is pretty good. Again, based on Bing Maps, right, using the Bing Maps decoder, they've added, I would say, these parts. But I think they are pretty successful. Based on what I read, also, it doesn't conflict too much with the, say, other add-ons which are available. They made some changes in the latest edition, which I would say kind of prevents that. But of course, if you still see some issues, then report them to the developer. Also, if you want to kind of, let's say, sponsor the contributor, there's a link where you can, I would say, send him some money. So that's always good. And I said him, but it could be he or she, right? Because that always, I would say, let's try to be inclusive. You can see a lot of buildings over there, right? Some of them are still under construction, some of them are already finished building, so really cool. And one other thing is that you can download it for free, right? So it's for free, but if you want to sponsor the developer, then do that. Please do that, because there probably have spent a lot, say, a serious amount of time on developing this content. And it's really worth the fight. You can see that there are a lot of things which are being added compared to the default content of the city itself. So where can you get this great content? Well, you can get it via Flight Simulator 2. I will put the direct download link into the description of this video. And then you can click it and download the three downloads. Don't forget them. You need all three of them to have this beautiful city. Here ends this video. I hope you liked it. If you liked it, then consider to use the like button. If you got questions or comments, then feel free to post them in the comment box below. And if you want to stay up to date about new videos I'm posting, then make sure that you're subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.